biology.
Hello there and welcome to this class whereby today I'll want us to look at the external and the internal structures of the teeth. So whereby we see that the mammalian teeth has three main zones whereby the first one is the crown, which is the portion above the gum. So the next one we have the roots, which is the portion below the gums, which is mainly covered by the cement. Then lastly we have the neck, which whereby this is a region between the crown and the root of the teeth. So we see that incisors and canines have only one root, whereby premolars have two roots and then molars have three roots. So fast forward, let's look at the internal structure of the teeth, whereby we see that the bulk of the teeth is made up of the enamel, we have the dentine, we have the pulp cavity, the cement, and finally the periodontal membrane. So let's look at the enamel. It's mainly the non-living layer made up of calcium phosphate and the carbonate. So it mainly protects the inner delicate parts, and also it is used for cutting and grinding of the food. So let's look at the dentine, which mainly comprises of cells, living cells, which secrete the enamel. So the next phase we are going to look is the pulp cavity. So the pulp cavity mainly contains the blood vessels and the nerve endings. And what's the function of the blood vessels? It supplies the teeth with essential nutrients. So what of the nerve endings? They detect and help respond to stimuli of coldness or hotness of a substance. Let's look at the cement. So the cement is made up of spongy calcareous material that fixes the teeth inside the jawbone. So after the cement, finally, let's look at the periodontal membrane, whereby this is a tough membrane made up of the collagen fibers between the cement and the jawbone. And what's the function of the periodontal membrane? It holds the teeth securely in the jawbone. So lastly, we are going to look at the dental diseases that we have. So first of all, we have dental caries, and the other disease we are going to look at is periodontal disease. So let's begin with dental caries. What is dental caries? So this is mainly brought about when bacteria on top of the teeth or food substances left on the teeth tend to corrode the crown or the enamel of the teeth. So what really happens is that these bacteria feed on the food that are right inside or right on top of the teeth, and then they multiply and they release acidic compounds, whereby these acidic compounds are the one responsible for corroding the enamel, leading to dental caries or tooth decay. So when the acid reaches the pulp cavity, a strong sharp pain may be felt, whereby this strong sharp pain may eventually lead to the removal of the teeth. So let's look at the other disease, which is the periodontal disease. So the periodontal disease is mainly brought by the inflammation of the gums, whereby there might be opportunistic infections. Like for example, we have the pyorrhea. So what's the pyorrhea? So pyorrhea, this is a disease of the teeth, which mainly leads to the loss of the teeth, whereby the connective tissues that are responsible for connecting the teeth become infected, and thereby their strength in holding the teeth declines, thereby leading to the loss of the teeth. So let's look at the other one infection. The other one is opportunistic disease, which is gingivitis, which mainly is the inflammation of the gums. So the gums may become red, they may swell, they may bleed, and also pus may ooze out of the gums. So what are the treatments for these diseases? So the first treatment will say that we may visit the dentist regularly for a teeth checkup. The other one, we might have root canal treatment. The other one, which is the most easy, we should take foods that are rich in vitamin A and vitamin C. So let's look at the dental hygiene. How can we maintain our teeth to be clean and healthy? So the first hygiene is that we should brush our teeth regularly. Also, we should regularly visit the dentist. Also, for the teeth, we should use the teeth for only the correct purpose. And then we may say that we should always use fluoride toothpaste, as this toothpaste makes teeth even to be more stronger. So let's meet now on the next class as we continue to discuss more on digestion. Biology.